because of the spirit that dwells in us. Thank you, Lord, thank you, Lord, thank you, Lord, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Shall we all shout amen?
Amen.
Oh, amen. I am not happy to be in the presence of the Lord. Somebody shouts hallelujah.
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 My topic for today is the word of God and the word that saves. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tell your neighbor the word that saves.
The word that saves.
The word that saves.
The word that saves.
The word that saves. Hallelujah. Our believers, we should know that it is only the word of God that saves. Nothing can save us except the word of God. You read our Bible reading again. According to the gospel according to St. John, chapter 1. Verse 1. It says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shines in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. Hallelujah. And the light shines in darkness, and darkness comprehended it not. We are talking about the Word of God, believers, and the Word of God is for Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And Jesus Christ is for the Spirit. So whenever we read the Word of God, the written Word of God, we have the written Word of God, the spoken Word of God, and the living Word of God. Listen to what Jesus Christ said according to Revelation chapter 1 verse 17. When John bowed down, when John fell, Jesus Christ would touch him with his right hand and said, I am the first and the last. I was dead, but now I am alive. Hallelujah. I was dead, but now I am alive. I am the living God. So Jesus Christ is what? The Word of God. Jesus Christ came so that we have life. John chapter 10 verse 10. He said what? Satan came to steal, to kill and to destroy. But I have come that you may have what? Life. And have it what? Abundantly. So without the Word of God, that is Jesus Christ, we don't have life. We are lifeless. Hallelujah. That is why Jesus Christ came. So when we are talking about the Word of God, in the beginning God created everything through what? The Word of God. God said, let there be light, and there was what? Light. It reminds us of what the book of Proverbs said. Hallelujah. That the Word of God is powerful. The book of Hebrews, the Word of God is what? Powerful and quick. God said, let there be light, and there was what? Light. So if we have to understand the Word of God, hallelujah, things are going to turn around, hallelujah.
Amen.
Things are going to turn around for our good once we understand the Word of God. For the written Word of God reveals what? The living Word of God, which is Jesus Christ. Because Jesus Christ is the what? Living Word of God. So the more we acquaint our spirit, the more we feed our spirit with the written Word of God. That is the God breath. Because it says all scriptures are what? God breath. So the more we feed our spirit with the living, the written Word of God, the more the living Word becomes real to us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So this morning, we are going to look at how the Word of God saves us and what the Word of God does to us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And it says the Word of God heals. The Word of God heals. Nothing can heal us except the Word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are reading a scripture from Proverbs chapter 4, verse 20 to 22. Got someone read it? Proverbs chapter 4, verse 20 to 22. Can someone read it?
Proverbs chapter 4, verse 20 to 22. It says, my son, attend to my words. Incline thy eye unto my saying. Let them not depart from thy eyes, keep them in the midst of thy heart. For they are life unto those that find them, and health to all thy flesh. Amen.
Amen.
It says, verse 20, my son, attend to my words. My son, attend to my words. Incline thy ear unto what my sayings. What is the word that Proverbs is talking about? It's talking about the word of God. That is Jesus Christ. My son, attend to my words. Incline thy ears unto my sayings. So now we are talking about how the word of God heals. Hallelujah. We are talking about spiritual healing, which takes effect in the body. Hallelujah. My son, attend to my words. Incline thy ears. We have something called hear and heed. But nowadays, people want to heed, but they don't want to hear. Do we get it? Because without hearing, there's no way you're going to heed. And what are you listening to? What are you hearing? It is the word of God that what heals. Have you forgotten that he himself took our infirmities and bore our sicknesses? Hallelujah. He took away our infirmities and bore our sicknesses. He nailed them what? On the cross. He took them. What is that? It is the word of God. So if you hear the word of God, you are going to be what? Healed. Nothing can heal you except the word of God. Hallelujah. Because he shed in our flesh, he shed in our humanity, so that through death he might break the power of he who holds what? The power of death. And that is what Jesus did. Hallelujah. That is what Jesus did. So once the word dwells in you, it's the word that is going to save, because the word is what? Spirit. Hallelujah. So once the Spirit dwells in you, nothing can save you, because you've inclined your ears into what? God's word. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Let's read the scripture. Luke chapter 5, verse 15. I want to reveal something to you. Hallelujah. Luke chapter 5, verse 15. We are talking about hear and heed. Can someone read it for me? Luke chapter 5, verse 15. Luke chapter 5.
Luke 5 verse 15.
Yeah.
However, the report went around concerning him all the more, and great multitudes came together to hear and to be healed by him of their infirmities.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
It seemed that so much more when they a fame abroad of him, and great multitudes, they came together to hear and be healed. We are talking about what? Jesus Christ. When Jesus Christ was evangelizing, he said great multitude, they came together to what? Hear and be healed. They came together to hear and be healed. As I said earlier on, there's no point that you're going to be healed without hearing the word of God. Because the word of God is so powerful. So once it gets into your system, it heals you. Someone might think, but how am I going to get healed? I have this sickness, cancer. We are talking about physical sickness. Hallelujah. But you should know that God wants us to do what? The Spirit. Because God is Spirit. And it makes us what? Spiritual beings. So the healing we are talking about is what? The Spirit. You receive the healing within, then it takes effect on the outside. Listen to what Abraham said. God had already promised him a child. But Abraham, Sarah was thinking about her age. At the age of 90, scientifically it's what? Impossible. Naturally it's impossible. Hallelujah. At the age of 90, it's not possible. But Romans chapter 4, it was talking about what Abraham said. God told Abraham, consider not. So when we are talking about the ability of God's word to heal, we are talking about the Spirit. Because you see the Spirit what? You see the healing through the Spirit. No one can contact God with our body, physically. You cannot walk to God. God, I'm here, I've come, your son is here. No, we contact God through what? The Spirit. So when we are receiving healing, it is through what? The Spirit of God. And the Spirit of God is what? The Word of God. The Word of God. Hallelujah. It says great multitudes. They what? They came to hear and be healed. great multitude came to hear, and he let me reveal something to you. In Mark chapter 6, verse 5, you know that Jesus didn't do much in Nazareth. That was where he was born. Do you know why? Because the people they didn't want to listen, they didn't want to hear. They didn't want to hear the word of God because they thought they knew him. Oh, this is a carpenter's son. What can he do? We know this guy, this small guy. So they didn't want to incline their ears unto the sayings of God. So there was no healing. Jesus didn't do much. If we read Mark chapter 6, verse 5, it's there. So as believers, if you want to receive healing, it is through the word of God. Nothing can be done. Nothing can be done without the word of God. Hallelujah. So you hear and be healed. That's why he says, my son, incline thy ears unto my sayings. And verse 21, he says what? Let it not depart from your eyes. Let it not depart from your eyes. Keep it in the midst of what? Thy heart. That is the words of God. Attend to my words. Incline thy ears unto my sayings. Let it not depart from thy what? Eyes. Keep it in the midst of thy heart. In your spirit. Hallelujah. So if the word of God dwells in you. Romans chapter 8, verse 7, it says, if the spirit of he who raised Christ from the dead lives in you, he who raised Christ from the dead will give life to what? Your mortal bodies. The world cannot accept him. But we can, because what? We know him. And he what? He lives in us. That is the spirit. That is the word of God. You didn't shout amen.
Amen.
That is what? The spirit of God. So if you incline thy ears unto the word of God, you receive healing. And healing comes by what? Faith. Hallelujah. Because once you contact God through the spirit, you know within that you've been healed. But physically, you still feeling the pains. That is where faith what? Comes in. Abraham believed in God. And that was accounted to him as well. Righteousness, that is faith. So now I know I have healing within. But so my body, my physical being is still in trouble. Hallelujah. So once we believe the words of God, we keep it what? In the midst of our hearts. We have overcome sickness. Because he took all our infirmities and bore all our sicknesses. Say, there's no way sickness can rule over us.
Yes.
He took everything. Everything that condemned us, that stood against us. He nailed it to the cross. Ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall what? Set you free. What is the truth? It is the word of God. I am the way, the truth, and the life. So Jesus Christ is what? The word of God. He is the truth. So once you know him, you are free. Free from what? Sickness. You are healed. Hallelujah. So healing, you receive healing what? In the spirit. And it manifests itself what? In the flesh. Don't consider not the physical things. Hallelujah. Consider not the physical things. Consider not. But look unto Jesus, the author and finisher of what? Our faith. What is that faith you are talking about? Believing in the word of God. Believing that yes, although I am sick now, but I am healed because he took all our infirmities and he bore my sicknesses. Hallelujah. So it is only the word of God that is able to heal you. My second point, the word of God gives power and authority. The word of God gives power and authority. Let's read Colossians chapter 1, verse 15 to 17. Colossians chapter 1, verse 15 to 17. The word of God gives power and authority. Colossians chapter 1, verse 15. I read verse 15. Who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature? It's talking about Jesus Christ. For by him were all things created, that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers, all things were created by him and for him. He is before all things and by him in all things. It says what? All things were created by him and for him. Listen to the English. All things were created by him and for him. If you're in possession of something, or if something is for you, you have what? Authority over that thing. You can manipulate that thing anyhow you want it, because it is what? For you. So all things, and the mention of principalities, powers, dominions, all those things are what? Made for you. For who? Jesus Christ. For who? The Word. So if the Word dwells in us, automatically we have a power and authority over principalities. Hallelujah. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10 to 14. We're talking about principalities. We do not war against flesh and blood, but what? Against principalities, powers, rulers of darkness, and wicked spirits, what? In the heavens. And now it says here that all those things were made for him. So if we have the Word, if the Word dwells in us, there's no way we are going to fear powers, principalities, or authorities, because they are our, they were made for us. Hallelujah. They were made for us. Ephesians chapter 1, it talks about the power and authority God gave us. God gave us what? Power and authority. Power and authority to overcome all these. When he died and resurrected, do you know what he told the disciples? All authority in heaven and on earth has what? Been given unto me. Therefore, go. Hallelujah. Before then, we had no power, we had no authority. We were in the Word. And the Bible says what? The Word is what? Belongs to Satan. But Jesus Christ came and through the blood. Listen, he says, according to Revelation chapter 2, verse 11, he overcame them by what? The blood of the Lamb and the words of his testimony. What is the Word? What is the Word? Hallelujah. That is the same word we are talking about. So when the Word dwells in us, automatically we shall overcome what? All powers and authority. So now what we have to do is what? We have to enforce that victory. We do not war. We are not warring as Christians, but we should rather rest and enforce that victory. Colossians 2:15 says, having spoiled all principalities and powers, in other words, having exposed them, having shattered them, he made what? He made a public spectacle. He made them a public spectacle. They were made to what? Announce. And announce is what? They were reduced to nothing. We all do agree that Satan has power. Hallelujah. But Jesus Christ came so that we may have life and have it abundantly. So as believers, it is not scriptural that some people think we are warring. We are in a fight. You see, there are three types of churches. We have the defeated church, the militant church, and the triumphant church. With the defeated church, they think or they assume that they've already been defeated by Satan. And the militant church, hallelujah, they are those who think they are warring. They are warring to get over Satan. They are in a war with Satan. But the triumphant church, which is scriptural, it says what? Having cancelled all the legal indebtedness. Hallelujah. Having cancelled, he nailed it what? To the cross. Having spoiled all principalities. That's why he has given us that power and authority. So as believers, we are to enforce that power. We are to enforce that victory. That is why they're giving thanks, giving joyful thanks unto God, who has given us victory through what? Jesus Christ, through the Word of God. So the Word that dwells in us has given us victory. Jesus wouldn't have said about, wait for me. Occupy till I come. Occupy what? Occupy till I come. Listen. Jesus had already defeated Satan. So he gave us the gun. So Satan is on the ground and we have the gun. We are what? Enforcing it. We are enforcing that victory. We are not warring with Satan. We are rather what? Enforcing that. That's why you have the authority to rebuke the devil in the name of Jesus. Submit to God and resist what the devil, and he will flee. Hallelujah. Because we have power, we have authority. We have power and we have authority. Hallelujah. So there's no way Satan can defeat us, because he's already a defeated foe. So if you know your rights and privileges in Christ, you will not fear the devil. You will not fear the devil. Hallelujah. It says, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, you shall ask anything and my Father will do it. So Lord, your words abide in me. I abide in you. I rebuke Satan in the name of Jesus. That is it. Hallelujah. You rest, you don't war. Because the more you war, the more you give Satan opportunity. He knows that you know nothing. You are ignorant. There are two things. It's either you know your rights and responsibility, that but you've decided not to exercise it, or you are ignorant of your rights. We are a triumphant church. We are not a militant church. Neither are we a defeated church, because Christ has already won the battle for us. So all what we have to do is what? Stand in our position. Stand in our position. He said, put all the armor. Put on all the armor so that you can what? Stand. It didn't say so that you can go and what? War. Because if you read carefully, all the armors except the Spirit of God, they are defensive. The helmet, the breastplate, they are all what? Defensive. These are the words of God. These are the word of God. They defend us. We're already in that position. Hallelujah. So we put all the armor so that we can what? Stand. When Satan approaches us, because once you're a believer, Satan is going to approach you. He's going to approach you not once, not twice. Most of him is going to approach you. So what you have to do is what? Let the word of God dwell in you. Let it not depart from your words. Eyes, keep them in the midst of your heart. Hallelujah. So once the word of God dwells in you, you stand on the word of God to rebuke Satan, and Satan will work power. Because demons tremble at the name of what? Jesus. Hallelujah. Demons tremble at the name of Jesus. I'll tell the last point. It says the word of God what? Saves. See, if you're talking about speaking the word of God to the unsaved, it's only the word of God that is able to save them. Shall we read Acts chapter 19, verse 17 to 20? Acts chapter 19, verse 17 to 20. Acts chapter 19, verse 17 to 20. I read, and this was known to all the Jews and Greeks, also dwelling at Ephesus. And fear fell on them all, and the name of the Lord Jesus was magnified. And many that believed came and confessed and showed their deeds. Many of them also, which used curious arts, brought their books together and bent them before all men. And they counted the price of them and found it 50,000 pieces of silver. So mighty grew the word of God and prevailed. Hallelujah. When Paul went to Ephesus, there was this god of Ephesus, Diana, the goddess of Diana. That was the god that Ephesians were worshipping. But do you know what Paul did? Paul didn't war with the people. Hallelujah. Paul did just one thing. He spoke the word of God. He spoke the word of God. Hallelujah. And he says the word of God prevailed. The word of God prevailed in their hearts. So it is only the word of God that saves. Nothing can save the unsaved except the word of God. Hallelujah. Paul didn't war with people. It was just with the word of God. Because the word of God is powerful and quick. The word of God is powerful and quick. So the word prevailed in their hearts, and they were transformed from what? Darkness into the kingdom of the Son of God. Hallelujah. Because God will transfer us from what? Kingdom of darkness or dominion of darkness into the kingdom of His Son. So through Jesus Christ, through the word of God, we were saved. So it is just through the word of God that saves. Hallelujah. Nothing can save us except the word of God. Because when you read Luke chapter 14, verse 18, it was talking about the account of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ didn't pray deliverance, he preached. And the people were delivered. Do you understand? Jesus Christ preached, they heard and they were delivered. He preached deliverance. So it is only the word of God that can be effective in people's lives, that can prevail, that can strengthen people, that can save people. So, beloved, this morning, all what I want you to know is what there's nothing you can do without the word of God. Remain in me, abide in me. If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask anything you want, and my Father will what? Will give. It is my Father will. My Father will go. My Father will give you. So it is a condition. In Jeremiah, it says, Jeremiah 33:3, call unto me and answer thee, and show you great and hidden things. Call unto me and I'll answer thee. But in this our system, if you remain in me and my words will abide in you, do we understand the difference? You see, the old scriptures, the Old Testament was for the what? Spiritually dead people. But we are what? In the new life, Jesus Christ, we know we are born again. Our life has changed. We have the nature of God in us. So once we remain in Him and His words abide in us, He's going to provide everything for us. Hallelujah. Because He watched over His words, but fulfill it. I, God, I watch over my words to fulfill it. Because without the word of God, you pray in the dark. You wake up and you start, hey, baba, hey, baba, hey, baba. Nothing will happen. You are praying in the dark. Because all your prayers should be based on what? The word of God. God said it, that I watch over my words to what? Fulfill it. So whatever God has said, so when you wake up and pray, you say, God, you've already defeated the devil. So the devil has no authority over you. You exercise authority. You are in that position. Hallelujah. You are in that position to what? Rebuke the devil. Resist the devil and he won't flee. He will flee. He can't. You're not doing it in your name. Neither in someone else's name, but you're doing it in the what? The name of Jesus. He said he's been given the name above every name, that at the mention of his name, every knee under the heavens and the earth shall bow. So at the mention of the name Jesus, every knee will bow. That is why we don't go with our own name, but we go with the name of Jesus, because he has what? Defeated the devil. And it's only the word of God that is going to save you, that is going to heal you. Hallelujah. Spiritually.